Steve Schmidt, I follow you on Twitter. I know you've been very engaged this weekend. And I know that in your view, Joe Biden isn't just going to have to convince Americans that the vaccine is safe and we need to take it to protect ourselves and our communities. He isn't just going to have to rebuild an economy. He isn't just going to have to reboot our alliances badly damaged by 4 years of Donald Trump's arbitrary and capricious conduct on the foreign policy stage. It seems to be your view that he's going to have to sell democracy again to the 76 million Americans who were willing to throw it down the drain after November.
There's no question that that's true. Look, I agree with Claire. Today is a happy day. It cements the reality that Donald Trump has been fired by the American people, and he will not have political power in this country come noon at January 20th. And that's a very good thing from where I sit. But at the end of the day, we saw American democracy poisoned over the course of November. American democracy relies on faith and belief in the legitimacy of the system from the people who grant it authority under our system of rule. What it requires is one side being able and willing to lose an election, to concede power temporarily in that virtuous circle of American democracy to the other side that captures more votes and wins elections. But we should all be terrified of what we saw this weekend in Washington, D.C. And we should think about it. What is it that we saw this weekend in Washington? What was it? They weren't wearing brown and black uniforms like they would have in Italy or in Germany in the 1920s or 1930s, but they're the same people. What we saw was right-wing violence in the nation's capital. This is political violence. This is a fascistic organization. When you have more than a majority of the Republicans in the House, through their signing of that amicus brief, making a political declaration, and let's be clear about this, it's not a legal declaration. It's a junk lawsuit. It's like something out of a Seinfeld episode. It's a political declaration. And it's a declaration of repudiation against our independence, against the fundamental and most notional ideas and ideals of the country. And that political declaration is one that you can't walk back from. They've crossed the Rubicon, so to speak. So when you look at House Republicans now, you should look at it through this prism. Liz Cheney is the leader of the conservatives in the House of Representatives. Kevin McCarthy is the leader of the House autocrats. And so when 126 of them have crossed that line, asserting that Donald Trump won an election, that they all, every one of them, except the handful of truly, truly crazy ones, know for sure intellectually that, in fact, Joe Biden won. Right? That the fact that they did that, that they're willing to poison American democracy, means that there's two sides in this political debate in this country and that American politics is realigned. There's a pro-democracy coalition, and there's another side. And on that other side, which is trying to throw out hundreds of thousands of black votes to keep Trump in power, who's faithless to the ideas and ideals of American democracy, we can never lose another presidential election to these people again, because maybe next time the leader will be more able, more competent, and the plan will look more detailed and more organized and less like a farce. But this is a dangerous hour we find ourselves in the country, and nobody should be naive about that.
Steve Schmidt, do you have any doubt that Donald Trump would have stolen this election if at any of these junctures, either the recounts or the legal challenges or harassing and pressuring the electors, and I think Pence has a role to play next week. I mean, do you have any doubt that it was Trump's intention to steal the election?
I have no doubt at all. The unknown in this equation is how many people would cross that river with him that would seek to repudiate the American idea and ideal in the sacrifice of 13 generations of American patriots in blood who gave us our American birthright. None at all. What's surprising is how many people did it with them, that we have 17 or 18 out of 25 Republican attorney generals signed on to this nonsense to disenfranchise the will of the American people. it was rejected and they lost. But we know, we now know that a very substantial part of the Republican political establishment in this country is hostile to democracy. We've never seen something like this before. So like we're seeing all over the world, we have seen the conservative movement metastasize into this populist menace that's come out of the other side with a lot of fascistic markers, that's autocratic and is not faithful to the ideas of American democracy, which have bound both parties together for all of their history, and before that, through the 244-year history of the United States.
Hey there, I'm Chris Hayes from MSNBC. Thanks for watching MSNBC on YouTube. If you want to keep up to date with the videos we're putting out, you can click subscribe just below me or click over on this list to see lots of other great videos.